What's up, everyone? It's the Busch Gardens Junkies here.
Hello.
And, well, it looks like they just opened up the tolls for the parking. So we are on our way Friday. Looks like there is some kind of group here. A whole bunch of yellow shirts. We'll probably see them when we get in. Hopefully it's a small group. Parking was backed up quite a bit. Not quite out to the road yet, but it was filled up quite a bit, and there's a lot of people not filling up the spots. So let me get my pass out ready to show them that I can get in and park. And I will talk to you later. We are heading over to our front row spot. Yeah, I think we'll take the third spot today. Yeah. There's the entrance, and we found out that Gert is already here in the front of the line, hopefully saving us a spot. Well, from the looks of it, there might be a couple of groups. So, we will see. And there we go, I spotted Gert. There is Gert right over there in the front of the line. Hey, Gert! Slow down. Hey, as you know, I come here. Every time I come here, I come over here to guest relations to pick up my rap sheet. And guess who I find? Willie!
What up, everybody?
Hey, everybody.
Good morning.
Good to see
you. Good morning, everyone.
How are y'all doing today?
Oh, we're doing great, Willie.
Fantastic. Let me get your thing for you.
This is our buddy Willie here, and he's getting a special on YouTube this week again.
Oh my God.
Always enjoy seeing Willie.
Good thing I'm not hiding from the authorities.
Oh, good thing. Yes. Well, are we supposed to be hiding from the authorities for some reason?
No.
Okay, not Willie, right? Willie's a good guy.
I'm not hiding from anybody.
And always appreciate Willie, and hopefully his supervisor is here hearing this.
Oh, they'll see that.
They'll see it.
But I appreciate that.
Bringing a smile to all of us every day that we come here. And if we haven't mentioned it on Facebook enough, Willie, this is our man.
I'm so glad y'all come every day.
And this is a wrap sheet. This is for the ride accessibility program. This is not a fast pass to get to the front of the line. You still have to wait. They give you a time, and you come back at that time that they state, and you get to ride the ride.
And there you are.
There you are. Thank you, Willie.
It's great. Thanks, bro. Enjoy. Have
fun. You too.
We'll see you soon. How's the wife?
She's somewhere. Now we saw Gert head over here in this store, I think. Did Gert head over here? Did Gert slide through here? She probably went over there to get her coffee and do you know where we pick up the pass member fridge magnet, the Iron Gwazi fridge magnet?
At the Iron Gwazi shop.
at the Iron Gwazi shop. Thank you very much. Cookie Monster. We are flowing through here. I'm pretty sure Gert came up this way. She saved us a spot in line. Yeah, there she is. Good morning, Gert.
Good morning.
Ooh, birds. Looks like the first riders of the day. Yeah, it's too bad this tree's in the way so you can't watch them drop. And there they go. Everybody, this is Grace Ann, ride operator attendant for Iron Gwazi, giving us our time.
You guys are good to go now.
Good to go. And we go that way. Yeah, we do. Thank you. And here we go up the ramp. Ooh, that came close. Yes. The other one. You can slow it down a little bit. Sheesh, you don't have to be a speed demon. Oh, team members only. Let's close that. Always concerned about safety. I'll have to check that when I get back because I didn't get the lock in the hole. But there she goes, the speed demon. Ay, 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 ay. Now, let's see who we have here. Got our buddy Christian here.
What's going on?
Hey, there you go.
How you guys doing this morning?
Oh, we're doing great. Anything but the first and last row, right? Yeah.
Yeah. Basically.
Okay, there you go. Good to see you.
Thank you.
Yep.
And our other buddy over there, Jaden. And here comes our train. Now this is gonna be our ride number 23. As the crowd is really starting to pick up here on a Friday. Yeah, a lot of crowds. Everybody excited to ride Iron Gwazi? Nope. This is gonna be 23. We're gonna have some fun. So, we got Jaden over there. We got Christian over there. Andrew back there in the line. And the line is starting to get packed. Right now it's 30 minutes. Okay, reverse view. Yeah, it's a little cold. So.
I did it the whole time.
I have arms up. I don't care.
That was great. Back half. Yeah, she's getting warm again. Getting a little faster, more intense. Still a good ride. Still a good ride. Now, I want to put a big shout out to all, I think there's now 135 of you. Thank you for the subscriptions. Yay! Well on our way to 200 subscribers by the end of this year. So don't forget to share, like, and subscribe. See that red button down there? Go ahead and hit it. Well, like you just caught it, we rode Iron Gwazi for the 23rd time. Yes. And now it is 60-minute wait, guys. Yeah. You got to get here first thing in the morning.
Early.
Early in the morning to catch a good couple of rides in. And yeah, and this is a weekday. This is Friday. Well, it's kind of weekend. But yeah, 60-minute wait. Is the best part right there. Down she goes.
Excellent, excellent. Alrighty.
And that's 3 second air time right there. And then what I like to call the gator death roll. Yeah, kangaroos. Aren't they cute? Oh, and then we get the sloths. Lions and tigers and elephants and giraffes. But the ruse caught my eye. Of course, we are in excursions, and during the food and wine festival, they are serving up a drink called the 91 degree drop. As if the 91 degree drop on Iron Gwazi isn't enough, you can have it with some vodka. Also, the Iron Gwazi fizz here at
the Food and Wine Festival at Busch Gardens in Excursions. We got gin, lavender, blue raspberry, and lemonade. I'm gonna have to try one of these drinks out later on today. Yeah, we saw the ruse in stuff form. Now we're gonna go check out the ruse in live form. The kangaroos be waiting for us. You wanna do food today? No food feeding today? Okay. And of course, we might have to mute it because of the fact that we got background music going on.
On the wall.
Oh, the cute little wallabies. Yeah. Too bad I can't block this music. Gonna get another copyright claim. So we're gonna try to talk over it quite a bit. So. Oh, and then we have a duck, a couple of ducks invading the area. Says, I want food. Yeah. Anybody got food? Okay, well, I see a turtle. But yes, folks, even here in the little pond, they took the swans away. All the birds are put away safely. So, we're good over here. And just to make sure, they are put away because of the avian flu, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, we put them all in the back so they're in covered spaces and everything.
Safe and, thank you.
Safe and sound.
Safe and sound.
Our 30 days was supposed to be up on April 9th.
Okay.
But there might have been another positive case.
Oh, no.
So that delays us another 30 days. And then because it's so hard to move the birds back and forth, after we have 30 days free, we may open the aviary.
Right.
But we may then wait another 30 days to move all our birds back here just to be absolutely positive that it's not an issue. But yeah, we miss them.
Yeah, we all miss them.
I know, it's...
I have seven or eight cockatiels at home.
Oh, wow.
A budgie, and, a leopard gecko and a ball python, but...
Awesome.
So, I'm an animal lover, so I know all about the birds, and so... And I miss my lorikeets, but at least we can see them.
I know, yeah, and that's...
Yeah.
That's,
yeah.
I wish people would stop trying to feed them.
Oh yeah, that's dangerous.
Cotton candy, popcorn.
Oh boy, hear that, YouTubers? Right?
Oh,
yeah. Yes.
I didn't know I was being.
Yeah. Well, you did a great job.
Oh, good.
And thank you very much for taking care of our animal friends and animal ambassadors. So, we love Busch Gardens and we love all the people that help keep everybody healthy here.
We love our animals.
Yeah, we love our animals. Thank you very much. Unfortunately, because of the avian flu, the kookaburra aviary is actually closed down. Wow. Yeah, the good old bird flu has done a lot of fun to this park. And as you heard from Kyle, the birds actually have to be put away
for at least 30 days since the last positive test or positive case of bird flu in the state of Florida. And that's not just in this local area, that's in the whole state of Florida. So there was recently another positive case of bird flu. So, yeah, we gotta wait another 30 days at least before we can see our bird friends again. We do get to see some ducks and turtles. No. And we get to see our lorikeet friends from afar. And guys, yeah, please do not feed the lorikeets bubblegum, popcorn, or cotton candy. That is a no-no. Some beautiful artwork. I hate filming this every time I come by here, but yeah, it is for the safety of our lorikeet friends. Our animal ambassadors need to be safe. So hopefully they will be able to open up soon. But we gotta wait at least another 30 days since the last positive case of bird flu. They're enjoying themselves though without us, it looks like. Which is okay. As long as they're safe and healthy. Shikra! And they're about to drop. And there they dropped. There's a little secret here. You see a couple of numbers up there. You see 3 and a 2. There's a number 2 on the upper right hand corner. And
that's train 2 right there.
This is train 3. This is train number 2 coming in. You see the number 2 on the front bumper? So that one is the one that is tested in the morning for the ADA riders. There goes train number 3. And train number 2 coming in the station. So we're here at Busch Gardens. And just to answer a few of the questions that I've been seeing in the YouTube channel. One of the questions is how crowded it will be. Well, it's hard to say, but usually the weekends are the crowd weekends, and the weekdays, Monday through Friday, are the light days. Today is a Friday. Q-times.com actually predicted that it would be packed today with over 80% capacity. But at the moment, it looks like only about 50% capacity. You can't really go by that too much because sometimes the weather takes an effect. And like Thursday, they predicted it would be 50 to 55%, and it was actually 0%. So they were way off on that one. But then again, it was raining all day on Thursday, and a lot of the rides were closed, so. But after the rain went by, I saw the queue times were like 5 minutes for everything. So, it all depends. Now, that would be a great day to come right after a rain. So, you gotta play it by ear. Check queue-times.com and see what the crowd calendar looks like for that day. The other question I saw was about drinks and snacks, bringing drinks and snacks in to the park. They will basically allow only water unless you have a special dietary need and or diabetes, some kind of health condition that requires you to bring in other snacks and other drinks in with you. You definitely cannot bring alcohol in. But this is Busch Gardens. This is not Disney. They serve alcohol here. So there you go. I hope that answers a couple of your questions there. If you have any more questions, feel free to put it down in the comment there, and I will definitely respond as soon as I can. And thank you for watching, and thank you for hanging on with us this past year and a half or two. We're going to be going ahead and riding some more rides and enjoying the park like we normally do. And what we normally do is, ride the rides, look at the animals, talk to people. And if you ever see us, I'm usually wearing this colorful shirt. It's the Busch Gardens Tampa Bay fluorescent yellow-green shirt with all the rides on it. And yes, I have credit for all of them. And or it may be the purple Iron Gwazi shirt. And you can definitely tell us out. We're the two older people that love the roller coasters. Here at Nola Eats, and I am in a mood for a beer battered shrimp po' boy. Yeah, that's what I'm in a mood for. It's also a smoked buffalo chicken po' boy, and they have an IPA and a smoked Bloody Mary. Yeah, I got it. And I was a little bit too hungry, so I already bit into it. But that is the shrimp po' boy with a nice little spicy sauce on it. And hey, we found a duck. This is delicious. Now Maggie got the Hawaiian barbecue pulled pork, which has a coconut rice, looks like pineapples, and pulled pork barbecue sauce. That looks good. Definitely one of the more popular rides here with a 75 minute wait now, guys. But it's that good of a ride. Yeah, there's a long line there. This is a Friday, so. But there's a lot of kids playing hooky. I see a lot of kids. Lots and lots of kids.
I see adults.
In the Miami Reserve, there's a lot of monkey business going on. Well, chimpanzee and apes. You know, through the Miami Reserve and they put some work walls up here. We got the one little dude just hanging out over here. Yeah, there's usually a little campsite here. They usually keep on changing things up. Doesn't look like they changed it up. That's a packed parking lot for Friday, people. Preferred was completely crowded. And, well, yeah, a bunch of buses.
parking. Record busy crowds here for a Friday. We went on Montu and, I think we saw at least eight buses out there. And they're laughing at it. So the preferred parking you noticed was packed. A lot of the parking was actually filled up. They didn't quite get into the overflow, but this is kind of like a weekend with the parking. It's amazing. Love the fact that Busch Gardens is crowded. I just don't like the long queue lines. So we're gonna head over to Pantopia and see what we can do about getting on Falcons Fury. But and then we'll play it by ear. Crazy guys. That there is Cobra's Curse. It's a one of a kind spinning coaster here at Busch Gardens. As you can see there, it's an elevator lift. Brings you up, drops you off, and then you're on for a ride. Yeah, and it spins. Well, the first third of it goes forward. The second third goes backwards. And then the third, it's free spin time. Check it out. They're up close.
That's for in case something bad happens.
Let's go check him out. Safari, while we spot the wild humans feeding the giraffes.
No! Stop! I do. Yeah. No.
This is the giraffes' natural habitat. They're being invaded by humans. Oh.
Nick said, come over and watch the basket.
Yeah, the monkey saw. I was like,
oh, yeah, baby. Zebras. Oh, look at this giraffe right here, Noah.
And then she just, like,
Come here. Hi there.
Got some food for you.
Oh, you better try to eat them.
Hold on.
I
don't
know that ride right here. Look, what's all the way in the back over there?
I forgot you were in it.
Come here.
Trying to take a look.
I think the giraffes.
Coming right over.
So cool.
See that one sticking out his tongue. Beautiful.
Uh-huh.
It does look like one of the younger ones.
Yeah.
Could be Stanley. Well, don't know. Can't really tell the differences between them all. I'm sure there's somebody that could, but yeah, we unfortunately can't tell the difference between them.
There's another one.
There's a couple
right.
of babies out there, too.
Yep. And here comes another group. Rare humans in a truck invading the Serengeti Plains. That'll do for the Edge of Africa today. Stay tuned for more info and more fun. Hey there.
Hi. How you doing, cutie?
The other one back there in the corner, hiding.
That's
our buddy Bhutan, I believe. And then they're about to drop. And we're coming through, and look who we see. Billy, our buddy Billy over here. Phil, I mean. Billy's.
He's around, he's here today.
Billy's here today.
Yeah, I'm not sure what he's up to right now.
Showing off the boys.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. So Phil here does the tours for the Serengeti Plain. And he also drives. Depending on what day it is.
That's right.
Billy is over here too. We're gonna go and take a look at the boys. And when we say boys, we mean Bubba and Jim.
Bubba and Jimmy.
Bubba and Jimmy. graceful little creatures. So Billy is here today. I got the two names confused between Billy and Phil. Both of them are great, but you gotta watch out for Billy. Billy can get you into trouble sometimes. Yeah. The boys are doing what the boys do best. Hide away in the back there. And wow. Just noticed the crowds. Holy cow. Yep. All right, well, since Bubba and Jim don't want to come out and show themselves, I guess we're going to have to move on. We were really hoping on hearing some special news about the new, well, it's a not a roller coaster, but it's a flat ride going back there, taking up the area where the Rhino Rally had its platform, loading platform and all. It's gonna be a S&S screaming swing. And here's a hint, it's called Project Jethro. If you do a search on Project Jethro, you'll find out all about it. Now here we have a couple of Asian elephants. And they're just enjoying the day, like we are. We were almost about ready to get on Falcons Fury, folks, but unfortunately there were high winds. So for safety reasons, they are not running temporarily closed because of the high winds. And thanks to our good buddies over here, Charlie and Wayne and Jay. Everybody, and the people in the booth too. So they're looking out for our safety, and we're just gonna hold off and wait a little while here, wait for the winds to die down, because of course Florida weather changes in a matter of seconds. There we go, some more people loving my YouTube channel. Yeah, we are on Falcons Fury. It keeps on going up and up and up. And well, we just finally got on because of it was temporarily closed due to the high winds. And they're very specific. Intamin says that if the winds are over 33.5, yes, 33.5 miles an hour, that this ride should not operate. And that is measured up there at the top. You see a little spinny thing? That's where they're measuring the wind speed. And now we get ready to drop. What the heck is that? Looks like. It looked like something dripping from the seat.
Oh. Your seat?
Well, between us or something. And that is Falcons Fury. Want to give a big shout out to Wayne and crew over at Falcons Fury. Thank you for subscribing, Wayne. All those guys there, the ride operators, they're so much fun and so much great information about Falcons Fury and some weird information. But yeah, there's quite a interesting things when we just sit around and talk. We may not have pink chickens, but we got tuxedo birds. Now these are African tuxedo birds. which means that they like the weather here in Florida. It's definitely a little crowded today, but we are sure enjoying it. And we're about ready to hop on to Iron Gwazi for the 24th time. And yeah, 24 times. It never gets old. And thank you all. We've hit 135 subscribers. So keep them subscriptions coming in. The marriage of steel and wood for a rare hybrid coaster named Iron Gwazi. Come up a little closer.
I'm up here.
Okay. Well, guys, it's been another great, wonderful day here at our happy place at Busch Gardens, Tampa Bay, Florida. We got in three more rides on Iron Gwazi. And we talked to a whole bunch of people, got some great information, and answered a few of your questions. So we're gonna call it a day. It's about 3:50, almost 4 o'clock, and we're gonna start heading home. And we're gonna start editing some video, and stay tuned. We might have some more good information for you coming up in the next couple of videos. So don't forget to subscribe, hit that bell so you get a notification whenever I post a new video. And we wanna thank you all.
Bye.
Bye.